Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay, let me introduce myself first. My name is Muhammad Ivan. I'm from PBI4C. I create this video for my assignment, teaching media with my lecturer, Mr. Kalayo, for final test. Okay, I'm group 2, and the topic is teaching and learning aids in lesson structure and instructional media. So the first is introduction, the use of multimedia in industries has been extensive, as it has been effective in increasing productive and retention rates. So where there is talk of teaching and learning aids in the lesson situation, by no means is the attempt to plan for their distinct teaching. And next is instructional aid theory. For many years, educators have theories about how to human brain and memory function during the communicative process. There is general agreement about certain theoretical factors that seem pertinent to understand the use of instructional aids. And the second is, during the communicative process, there are two theories here. And the sensory register of the memory acts as a filter as stimuli are received. The individual's sensory register work to sort out the important bits of information from the routine or less significant bits. Multimedia education has been extremely effective in teaching individuals wide range of subjects. Multimedia is changing the way we communicate with each other. And what is instructional media? According to AZQA 2007, instructional media cover whatever the teacher used to develop all the fifth sense: sense of sight, hearing, touch, smell, and taste, while presenting his or her lessons. What is the fifth sense? They consist of, the first is non-project aids, which include chalkboard and sites. And the second is pictorial aids, which include chart and pictures. And the third one is mobile. And the fourth is dimensional aids, and the fifth is projecting aids, which include films, strips, and slides, projector. And the last is books. We come to the summary. It is possible to talk past each other if we use different terms with various meaning. Whatever term we use, our ideal is the complete integration of media in teaching and do also into each lesson. In the following section, a closer look is taken of integrating media into teaching. From the finding of this study, it was concluded that when video is used in teaching, it enhances learner's positive attitude toward to the course. Also, it affects their performance. And the following, they are recommendations. The first is every teaching and learning activities should always be supplemented with media such as video or pictures maybe. And the second is teacher must have good training on the use of media. So teacher must have media like projector, laptop, smartphone, or etc. And the third is student favorite media must be investigated and used to teach them. And there are six following factors influence the selection of media for a particular lesson. The first is learning content, and the second is The third is teaching strategies. Fourth, student characteristic. And the fifth part, practical limitation. And the sixth is and the last one is preference of the lecturer or teacher. Okay, I think that's all for my presentation today about teaching and learning aids in lesson structure and instructional media. I think that's all. I'm sorry for my